Good evening. I'm here with Amy Devereaux. Amy is one of three artists exhibiting this month at the Clayton Center. Amy, thank you for participating in this.
Thank you for having me.
Your work is photography, and it's very interesting. Why don't you tell us a little something about yourself, how you ended up in Clayton and how you got involved in photography and so forth.
I'm originally from Raleigh, and I've lived in lots of different places, and the last place was Santa Barbara before I moved here, and I was wanting to buy a house, and Clayton was affordable, and I love it. I live in the Cleveland area. I live in a very quiet neighborhood. It's off of a cul-de-sac, so I love it, and I have almost an acre, so I'm really grateful that I could, you know, and I have a beautiful garden that I've created.
I'm very familiar with Santa Barbara. I lived in Ventura. In fact, I went to college in Ventura, and I can tell you that's not affordable living.
No, it's not, and that's and I have a master's in library science, and I couldn't get a school library job because I didn't student teach in a university program, so I just said, I'm going home to North Carolina.
Well,
so.
Your photography is from India.
Correct.
So tell us about your wonderful trip to India, and you're dressed the part tonight.
Yes,
you look very nice.
Got this in India too.
Yeah, I bet you did.
So, I discovered through the AARP magazine, Gate One Travel, and they include airfare, and I was able to go to India, and this time from Raleigh-Durham. Usually it's from New York or LA or Costa Rica, Miami, for $1,700, and that included airfare. And that included your tour guide, the hotels, most meals, even the little optional trips. And I do love to travel. I like to go to countries that have a different culture. So, I mean, I've already done Europe when I was younger. My mother's from England. She was a World War II bride. So I like to go to different places. So.
Well, I had some friends who were world travelers. And about their 60th or 70th country was India. And I spoke to them. In fact, I met them in New York when they got off the airplane. And they said, don't go to India as your first place overseas because it's very shocking. Tell us what you thought of India.
Well, I was prepared for the poverty, and actually I was pleasantly surprised. Delhi had a lot of trees. I didn't really expect Delhi to have a lot of trees, and other places did too. The only thing that really bothered me the most was the honking of the horns. In fact, our tour guide says that when he comes to the United States, the first thing he does when he gets a rental car, he disables his horn because he knows he's going to really make people mad because he just automatically just honks the horn.
Well, the work is beautiful. So. Taj Mahal, is it as spectacular as...
Yes, the thing that surprised me about the Taj Mahal, you know, everybody's familiar with that iconic picture, but it's a huge complex with a mosque on either side and a gateway buildings and large plazas. But the funniest thing about the time that I went, I didn't realize it was the hottest time of the year, so it was like 115 degrees.
It gets hot in India.
But it was great because except for the Taj Mahal, there would be very few people in all these tourist places, so I was able to get pictures of buildings with nobody around.
Well,
of course, I have some people pictures too. So
yes, you do.
You know, that was
well,
nice.
The work is interesting. The picture is worth 1,000 words, and these pictures are worth more than that. I'm here again with Carolyn Howard. Carolyn was here last month, where she won a judge's award in our annual CVA art fair. And she's back again tonight as one of the three artists this month. Carolyn, some of your art is right here behind us. It's always interesting. Your stuff is fun to look at. Tell us a little bit about what you do and how you do it.
Thanks, Larry. I think it's fun to look at because I have fun creating it. I've been an artist for a long time. Attended the Maryland Institute College of Art and Design in Baltimore, where I was reared. And ever since then, I have taught art, worked with children through adults, and created many, many pieces of art. I do commission work, portraits, and that kind of thing. But my love is to create mixed media because of the challenge, first of all, and secondly, because I never know exactly what the end result will be. I just go with it. Go with the flow. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the saying is you have to know the rules before you can break them. Well, I had so many art classes and workshops and so forth and taught for so long that when I do my mixed media, I just find a flow. I feel free to create and tweak it here and there and look at it for a while and then go back into it, because a collage, you can do that. Some media you cannot, but with collage, you can keep on working with it a little bit until you're happy with it.
Well, it's always interesting to look at, and we're always happy to have you here. I would just want to thank you again for participating in the art show last month and for contributing to our monthly art show here at the Clayton Center. We're happy to have her in the CVA, and Redruth, you have some beautiful work here tonight.
Well, thank you, Larry.
Tell us about the work that you have here and anything else you want to tell us about your art.
Okay, my paintings are acrylic on canvas. My style is impressionistic, and almost all my painting is done from life rather than from a photo reference or a sketch. I mostly just go out there with my little easel and do it. Whether there are bugs or whatever, I'm out there.
Well, you had one over there that was taken in the middle of winter. I hope you didn't stand out there for that one.
No, I did not, because I am a wimp. That is Cataract Falls in Indiana, and it was 24 degrees that day. Now, there's another painting of that same waterfall in the fall, and that one, I stood out there and I painted it, and I was very happy to do it. But 24 degrees, no. We don't go there.
So plein air?
Plein air.
Plein air is your thing.
Yes.
Now, you are trained to be an artist, and you've been an artist almost all of your life, is that correct?
Oh yes, forever and ever, since the dinosaurs roamed the earth. I went to art school and I've been a painter ever since.
Where did you go to school?
Cleveland Institute of Art in Cleveland, Ohio.
Well known. Well, no.
It's a good school.
Yeah.
It's a very good school.
It's still in existence.
Yeah. I went in the 60s, and then most art schools were crazy, but that was a normal art school. Life drawing, perspective, the whole bit.
There wasn't anything normal in the 60s.
Cleveland Institute of Art was.
Medrith, thank you so much for doing this, and I hope we'll get you back again. I know you have more work, I'm sure.
Oh, I have, and I'll be glad to. Thank you, Larry.
You're welcome. Next month at the Clayton Center, we have two artists that we're featuring. Rhonda Peters will be bringing photography here. And this one's very interesting. Maureen Wartzke is a fabric artist. Normally we have just paintings and photography and so forth, but this lady does fabric art. And if you don't know what that is, I'm not going to tell you. I'm going to ask you to come to the Clayton Center. Next month, if you want to come to the reception, it's going to be Thursday night, November 7th. Hope to see you there. Thank you. Good night.